Hi guys, my name is Betsy and welcome to a new video. Today's video is gonna be all about hair. So what I'm going to show you today is how I draw hair, and if you have been struggling with drawing hair in the past, I hope this video will help you. Let's jump right into it. So let's talk hair. I personally love drawing hair. Drawing hair is one of the most relaxing things to do when I draw new artworks, and I know a lot of people, other artists that I know, enjoy drawing hair as well. I know that drawing hair so it looks natural and like it's flowing and actually in movement can be somewhat hard sometimes, so I do understand that there is a certain struggle getting hair drawn right. There's some different styles of hair, obviously. There is straight hair, curly hair, and also a million variations of updos. Then we have very short hair for mostly males who have like very like trimmed down hair. But today we are mainly gonna focus on hairstyles for females and one hairstyle in particular, which is gonna be the curly hairstyle, because it's my favorite and it's, I think, the most fun one, the most adventurous one, and it's the one where you can play around a lot. So yeah, let's try to get into some tips that might help you to get better at drawing hair. My first tip is obviously get some references, and that basically goes for everything that has to do with drawing. You don't want your hair to look flat and uninspired and boring, and I mean, if you're going for a very simple style, like chibi style and stuff, yes, you have your own art style too. There is a certain way of making it more simplified, and I get that. But you want your hair to look like hair. And you can see in the artwork on the left that, does that look like hair? Does it just look like a Lego figurine where you just put the hair on? It looks very plasticky and unnatural. On the picture to the right, you can see how I have been drawing the same hairstyle, but in my own style. Obviously, it doesn't look like it's real hair. It looks stylized, it looks like my style, but it looks a lot more realistic and flowy compared to the left artwork. So references are your best friend. My second tip is get your brush strokes right. You can draw hair with one brush only and one brush size only, but I personally think, and that is just how I like it, I think it looks a little bit flat and uninspired. You can see it in the hair on the left that it looks very flat. It was done with one brush only and one brush width only. The right side has a little bit more depth to it because it has different thickness to it, and you can see it's maybe a little bit exaggerated. I put a little bit too much black on that, but you can see how it makes the hair look stand out more, and that is something we really want to go for, to make it look more realistic, healthy, and natural. My next tip is, when you are coloring, make sure you know how lighting works. Again, it's really good to look up references and see where the lighting is coming from, how it's hitting the hair, what kind of lighting and shadow is gonna show up on the hair. You can see me drawing three different styles. The left one is a very, very easy chibi style that I use personally only for like small chibi artwork, which is very simple. The middle one is a little bit more advanced, but also very simple still, but I use it from time to time for fun. And the right one is the advanced one that I use for more detailed artworks. So I'm gonna try to put these things that I just talked about to use, and we are gonna draw the character Aloy from the video game Horizon Zero Dawn. Aloy has very curly hair, and as I said, I enjoy drawing curly hair the most. Some people probably like drawing straight hair, but I don't. So the first thing you can see is that I did a sketch and I'm drawing my line work onto the sketch. And you can see right away that I'm doing the thing that I talked about with the line art, that I'm trying to do bigger and smaller brush strokes, making the lines more thick and thinner in certain places, just to give the hair overall depth to it. And again, this is totally personal, not everyone needs to do it, but I like it that way. I think the hair looks very healthy and natural, and I enjoy drawing my hair like this. When I'm done doing the line art, I'm making sure that everything is in the right place, obviously. I mean, after the line art is done, you can't erase it. But just to make sure, I look through everything one more time. You can see some single hair strands going out left and right a little bit. I do this to make the hair overall look more natural, because your hair is, even if it's obviously going in a certain direction and it's going falling in a certain way, there's always one or two hair strands that just go in a different direction, just like a tiny bit. They want to go a different way. And I think if you want the hair to look a little bit more realistic, you try to make the hair be chaotic. So it's basically planned out chaos, I guess. You don't just want the hair to fall down and all hair to be together, because in real life, hair is not just all cramped up together in one spot and they're just all falling down and look like cement. That's basically not how hair works. I'm starting to do the colors afterwards, and as you've seen earlier, I have different ways of normally put down colors and where the light and the shadow hits. And in this case, I try to go for the more advanced version because the artwork is more detailed. I put down a base color, and then over the base color, I put down a second color. You can see that I left out a lot of places where I want light to hit, so these areas stay white. I do this, I think, 3 times, and after the 3rd time, I go down with another color, and that's my darkest shade, to make the color pop. Normally, I would say you can literally just draw hair by having 2 colors. You have a dark color, a light color, and you use white for your highlights. In this case, I went for 5 colors in total to draw out the hair, to make sure that I give it enough depth. And just to make clear, because people always tell me, oh yeah, it looks like you don't take long and blah, blah, blah. This hair alone took me probably 6-7 hours to draw, because I took my time and it was relaxing and I just wanted to have fun with it. Overall, just saying, the end result, love it. I'm really happy about it. But you don't need to feel bad if you take your time for something in your artwork. Like, I like to take my time with hair, especially to get it right and make it look the way I want it to. And I'm really happy that I do so, because I have a good time and it looks nice in the end. So yeah, don't feel bad about it if you take a little bit longer for your artwork. It just means you care and you want to get it right, and I totally understand that. So what you can see me doing is basically putting down the last bits of color, of dark color, to make the hair have a little bit more depth to it. And honestly, I liked the dark color the best. It just made the overall hairstyle and the overall hair color pop a little bit more. And there's one more thing I'm gonna do now. It's I'm gonna take a yellow and put it near where the highlights are. And ooh, look at this. It just makes it look so good. I don't know. The yellow was a really nice touch at the end. I just feel like it makes the artwork look even better and the hairstyle look even better. And it's just, working with so many different colors felt really, really good when drawing this artwork, because I just think it made the hairstyle and the hair color look so vibrant and so beautiful. So I'm really, really pleased with that. So here at the end, I'm just drawing some of the clothes. It's not really important, but I just thought I might as well include it so I can talk a little bit more with you cuties. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. We can maybe do some more in-depth videos about hairstyles in the future. I just didn't want to do it with this video, because I like to keep my videos lighthearted and not too technical so everyone can follow them. Let me know what is your favorite hairstyle to draw. Do you like drawing hairs or do you think it's complicated and you struggle a little bit? Let me know in the comments and I hope you like how this artwork turned out. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you could take something away from it. I'm so sorry for the audio because the dog still sitting in the background scratching herself. What are you doing, dog, huh? So I'm really sorry if the intro and outro has been like a little bit noisy. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please give the video a thumbs up, like, subscribe, all that good stuff. Check out my social medias and I see you guys for a video next week. Bye bye. Oh, lum lum. Oh, lum lum.